Hi guys, today I want to get a hand on the Raspberry Pi Pico. It is an affordable Tinkerboard equipped with the powerful RP2040 microcontroller or MCU, which has two CPU cores. As a first step, I have to order it. Let's have a quick look. Okay, what do we get here? Yeah, that's the Raspberry Pi Pico board with the RP2040. And it's a quite good offer. I mean, it's cheaper, but I don't think the video is out at the date. But yeah, they often make these special offers, but even 612 is a good price, I think. When you think of what you get for it, what a great hardware. And let's see what they get here. They have different variants. Black. Black coding, 4 megabytes of flash memory. But I don't like these black codings because it's harder to see where the traces are. And I like transparency. And even 4 meg, Okay, there we have 16 meg. 16 meg flash memory is better, but still the black coding. No. And there we have a 16 meg as well. And that's great. And a purple coding. Yeah, you can clearly see where the traces are. I like that. Okay, let's remember that. Let's look further. So we have a black coding with type C connector. And we have type C connector black with 16 meg. Okay, and we have green coding, and that's with the micro connector, and probably the original one with just 2 megabytes of memory, of flash memory. And there we have it with type C. Okay, but still obviously with just 2 megabytes of memory. So my favorite is this one here, light purple, 16 megabytes. It's a nice coding color, traces are visible. 16 meg is the max memory they offer, and I have to admit 16 meg is more than I probably need, but you cannot have enough memory. That's my opinion. Okay, so I will order this one, and I will put a link in the description if you are interested in this product as well. But now it takes some days before it's delivered. Yeah, the chip costs as low as $1 per part. The part has 2 CPU cores, which is really fascinating. No programmer is needed, due to the integrated USB hardware. And when mounted on the Raspberry Pi Pico, you can program it by USB. It has a 32-bit architecture, which makes it suitable for higher numbers. It has a USB 1.1 interface on board. It has programmable IOs, which makes it suitable to adapt to other interfaces which are not supported. A free C compiler SDK is available online. Common interfaces like SPI, I2C are integrated. Common hardware features like timers, counters, interrupts, ADC, PWM are integrated. 264 kilobytes of SRAM, and typically more flash than 8-bit MCUs. That's for the pros. Now to the cons. No EEPROM is integrated. No flash is integrated, so an external flash chip is always required. Higher current consumptions than 8-bit MCUs. It's about 20 milliamps here. No low power mode, just sleep mode. No digital audio converter. And the QFN package is a hassle for hand soldering. In the meantime, I can search for a compiler suitable for the Raspberry Pi Pico. From my other videos, you may know that I prefer to program in C or C++. Thankfully, the Raspberry Pi Foundation has released a free Pico C SDK for Windows. That is the corresponding website. The release was on the 22nd of February in 2023, but now seems to be the right moment for me to step in. Let's scroll down a bit. There is the download button for the C SDK. With this package, it is possible to install all necessary parts at once. So I don't have to install all parts individually by hand. What a time and nerve saver. The package uses the MS Visual Studio Code tool as editor slash control tool. It is actually open source and can be used for other programming languages as well. They also provide several example codes. This makes the start so much easier. Here, they promote the debug probe for debugging, but as far as I know, I can also use a second Pico board for debugging. As I just ordered one board, I cannot test it currently, but debugging is always just for beginners. No, I'm just kidding. But for smaller projects, I just don't need it. Okay, my order from AliExpress has arrived. The shipping took just 7 days. Amazing. I now start the download of the C SDK package. By the way, would you mind to open your PayPal account and making a small donation right now? So I can buy a second Pico board and other devices to make videos for you? Seriously, I think there is no excuse. Okay, the download and the installation of the C SDK package has finished. That is the Visual Studio Code app. On the left side of the screen, you see the list of examples. I will go for the Plink code as a start. A click on the plink.c entry brings up the C code. Let's have a quick look on the code. It looks quite familiar to me. Includes definitions, GPIO setup and GPIO pin set and reset. But hey, what is that? They use a command called sleep-ms to delay the output into visible timings. That is clever. Obviously, the command puts the MCU into a low power state and wakes up after the specified time. But now I can compile the C code to see if the code throws some errors. For this, I simply make a right click on the plink.c entry here, and then I click on Compile Active File. This immediately starts the compiling process, as you can see in the terminal output. It compiled without errors. That was expected on a tested code. Now I want to quickly change the build variant, as I don't need the debug ballast. After this setting, the build process starts automatically so that all necessary files are generated. Usually, the build process is started by a mouse click on the build button on the bottom part of the window. Anyways, also the build finished without errors. The resulting files of the build I have found in the build folder, which is located in the same path as the example files. The file that I need for the programming of the Pico board is the blink.uf2 file. Now I have to connect the Pico board via USB to my PC. If the Pico board is new, it shows up as a mass storage device in the Windows Explorer without any extra action. If the Pico board was programmed before, it is always necessary to push and hold the boot cell button on the Pico board and then to connect it to the PC. I can now simply drag and drop the blink.uf2 file onto the Pico drive.
This simple file copying is all it needs to program the Pico board. If all worked well, the Pico board is already executing the program. Let's have a look at the board. Oh yes, it worked! The green LED is flashing! Happy days! My first Pico board programming was successful. Yes, it also shows that the Pico board I have bought is working fine. Of course, the Hello World Blink example was just the start. I have plans to use the Pico board, e.g. with the graphical LCD display or GLCD. I have tested this GLCD before, as you can see here, but have stopped it because the MCU needs to have a lot of flash memory to store the character sets and images for it. Too much for an ADTiny85 or PIC18F. But as my Pico board has 16 megabytes of flash memory, this teases me to try it again. But this will be part of another possible video. If you're not already a valued subscriber, you have now the chance to become one. For which projects do you plan or already use the Raspberry Pi Pico? Leave it in the comments. Stay tuned for more videos, have a great time, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.